looking mighty fine.
Tanglewood fall down.
Tanglewood fall down. Tanglewood fall down. All the way down to the ground. Now Tanglewood fall down. Got locked up in that county jail.
Tanglewood fall down.
Had no one to go my bail.
Tanglewood fall down.
That old judge said 90 days.
Tanglewood fall down.
Better change your ways.
Tanglewood pile down.
Tanglewood pile down. Tanglewood pile down. All the way down to the ground. Now Tanglewood pile down. Go! In a
bind.
Well, I think I'll run for president.
Tanglewood
pile down. Then I won't have to pay no rent.
Tanglewood pile down.
Tanglewood pile down. All the way down to the ground. Now Tanglewood pile
superlatives, setting the mood for our Saturday night. And that mood is a really special one, because tonight we are all gathered here for one reason: to celebrate the 30th anniversary of Marty Stewart as an Opry member. That is right. 30 years of bringing the country music message to Opry audiences, and 30 years of tending and feeding the very roots of country music. So to celebrate tonight, Marty has gathered the essential ingredients for the perfect stew of country music: Delta blues from John Tavius Willis, the humor of Gary Mule Deer, and the timeless sound of the Del McCurry Band. Hey everybody, I am Natalie Stovall, and y'all, if I had a 10-hour miniseries on HBO just to tell you all about Marty Stewart, it would not be enough. So, I'm gonna give you the Marty Stewart essentials. He was born with an old soul destined to be country music's keeper. He has learned from and played with just about every country artist who has shaped the genre. His soul holds the stories of the architects of country music, and his fingers hold the memories of nearly every legendary artist who's held a guitar pick. He is without a doubt a Renaissance man for this genre, and he is most certainly a jewel in the crown of country music. Once again, here is Marty Stewart.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Well, our job is for the next almost hour to take the roof off this place and take you with us. We're going to have a good show. I promise you. I promise. How about a hand for Professor Chris Scruggs on the bass?
Thank you.
Handsome Harry Stinson, cousin Kenny Vaughn.
Yeah.
These gentlemen, along with Mick Connolly, were elected into and inducted into the Musicians Hall of Fame this week. How about a hand for those superlatives? Keep your hands going. Clap your hands.
There's a girl trying to steal my heart, and I'm
tempted. Even though she could tear it apart, I'm tempted. In her eyes there's mystery. Every time she smiles at me, I know how it could be. Yet I'm tempted. Each time she looks my way, I'm tempted. Just a little more every day, I'm tempted. It's so hard to resist the thought of her sweet kiss. Can't take much more of this, I'm tempted. Tempted and try, deep down inside, I can't deny that I'm tempted.
I appreciate you coming tonight. This night, for the next few minutes, I'm filling it up with people I dearly love and cherish and admire, and superlatives.
Yeah. Yep.
You're going to find this hard to believe, along with Eddie Lang. We borrowed Eddie from Connie Smith's band. How about a hand for Eddie?
All right.
But superlatives, one of our great musical heroes of all time, the man from Alabama who plays the blues fiddle like nobody else. How about a hand for the great Kenny Lovelace to sit in with us? Come here, Kenny. Hey, pal.
I love you.
Love you too, buddy.
So here's the story. This guy's been our hero for many years. He went to work playing with Mr. Jerry Lee Lewis in 1967. How about that? All the way to the end.
Thank you, Marty.
All the way to the end.
Wow.
And none of those records, those great country records, would have sounded the same without you. Hit me a lick on that blues fiddle before we get started. That's all right. So I write songs sometimes just so I can hear Kenny play with us. Here's blues fiddle. So the song is called Rough Around the Edges, and somebody ought to count it out like this.
I woke up this morning with miles of life behind me. My friends and family worried, 'cause they don't know
where to find me. Once again, I beg forgiveness for another lost night in my soul. Some bad's got a hold on me, and it just won't let me go. Run around the edges, it's hard. Steady up, gain control. Look around the edges, the devil's reaching for my soul. Oh yeah. For the awful shape I'm in, I've shook 100 helping hands and go fall down again. People try to help me, oh, that just adds to all the shame. I straighten up for a day or two, then the bottle calls my name. It's hard to face myself. The mirror in the morning shows a man who looks like death. Can't seem to find a way, Lord, steady up.
Humana, proud partner of the Grand Ole Opry. It's not just healthcare, it's human care.
Well, hello, everybody. I'm Natalie Stovall, and I am just so proud to be here tonight and to get to chat with the man of the evening, Mr. Marty Stewart.
Let's talk about those pants. Those are cool.
I wore these for you, sir.
I appreciate it.
I borrowed these from Miss Tracy Gershaw, and the rumor is that you used to own the jacket that matched them.
So that's what happened to the pants.
Exactly.
Many years ago.
So 30 years of being an Opry member, 50 years of playing on this stage. I know that your brain is just filled with so many incredible Opry moments. What about during the pandemic when we kept the circle unbroken? There was nobody here but you and Vince and Brad all up on this stage.
Well, what I really hoped for, and I think Vince and Brad shared this too, is that was so early on in the pandemic. There was no vaccine, there was no nothing. And we were hoping that it would just send out a little hope and inspiration to people. Like there is a back door to this thing somehow, somewhere. But as usual, Vince had the best line. Somebody said, "What was it like playing to an empty house?" Vince said, "Oh, we mastered that years ago." We got that.
Well, that was such a special night. And this is such a special night for you. And not only are you playing, but you're doing part of the hosting as well. So I know that you've got to go back over and get prepared. So I release you to your...
Am I fired?
No.
Again? All right.
No, you're hired
you
for
covered.
It all.
How about
He's doing
Nan,
it all right. tonight. They told me I could only talk to him for a few seconds. But y'all, I also have to keep bragging on him because Mr. Marty Stewart and the Fabulous Superlatives last Tuesday were inducted into the Musicians Hall of Fame. Give it up. Along with the likes of Mr. Vince Gill, Don McLean, Billy Gibbons, and Ray Stevens, no big deal. Man, that was something that we all knew was coming. immediately. Now, also, Marty released a song just last week called Country Star. It's off of his new album called Songs I Sing in the Dark. This is a collection of songs that he said that he's always sung to himself, that he wanted to record and release to everybody. It's everything from the popular to the obscure is what I heard. Now, at this moment, it's time to get back to the show, so I'm going to give it back to Mr. Marty Stewart.
Thank you. Cousin Kenny Vaughn came up to me back in the spring of this year and said, I found a guy that you have to see. I thought I would never hear this kind of country blues again. The gentleman comes to us from Georgia tonight, and he is making his Grand Ole Opry debut, and I am such a fan.
Thank you.
I want you to put your hands together. Tear it up for Mr. John Tavius Willis. Go for it, John Tavius.
Change. I'm gonna move away and change my name. I said the world's in a tangle. What's going on? Going to a foreign land. Gotta make it my home. You could be having a good day at job. You get the blues when you turn on the TV, because the world's in a tangle. What's going on? I'm going to a foreign land. Gotta make it my home. Pick it a while. Such peace while we're living, but we gotta get it when we die, 'cause the world's in a tangle. What's going on? Yes. Going to a foreign land, I just got to make it my doggone. Say it one more time. I said the world's in a tangle. It's time to make a change.
Opry Live is sponsored in part by Dish Network.
John Tavius Willis, everybody! Congratulations! You just had your Opry debut! And not only that, it was spectacular, and you just got a standing ovation at the Opry. How you feel?
I feel good.
I think you better feel good after that performance. Now, okay. Do you feel like you were able to really remember what happened in that circle? Because a lot of artists say that during their debut, they kind of black out and don't remember it.
I think I remember it now. Maybe later, you know, because you know how it kind of blurry. But right now, yeah, I think I remember.
Now, is the Opry, is this stage one that you thought about playing along the way? As a blues artist growing up in Georgia?
Yeah, I think I thought about it. I've heard about it, you know, the blues kind of intertwine a lot with country. And I heard a lot about some older cats, you know, Uncle Dave Megan, the D4 Bailey, and them kind of guy. You know, I know... So I'm happy to be here, you know, keeping it going. That's a good little thing. I'm
happy
to be here.
It is. We're happy you're here. Now, how do you and Mr. Marty Stewart know each other?
Yeah, we had a mutual friend, and he told, you know, a friend of a friend, he told him about me. And we met each other a couple months ago at the... Rhyming Theater. So it hasn't been too long. We haven't known each other too long, but it seemed like we've been doing... He say I'm his cousin, so I take it.
I sure love that. Well, I read somewhere that you discovered the blues when you were 14 by watching a YouTube video of Muddy Waters.
Well, I think that's when it clicked to me. I kind of knew it, I realized it, because coming up in church, a lot of the blues elements are in there, but you don't really understand, you know, like the showmanship. I'm not saying one came before the other. I'm just saying the showmanship, the cadence of the voice, the instrumentation and stuff. And when I heard Muddy Waters play in this particular setting that he was in, it reminded me so much of his church with the call and response. And it all kind of just came together and snapped when I was like 14.
Wow. Well, we are so proud to have you here. Go enjoy the rest of your night backstage here at the Grand Ole Opry.
Thank you,
Jontavious Willis. Y'all keep that applause going. I'm going back into TV. Make me look good. Welcome back to Opry Live. Natalie Stovall here. Now, the most wonderful time of the year is upon us. The holidays are here, and with it has come the most wonderful sponsor. Toys for Tots is helping us present the show tonight. And each year, Toys for Tots hands out millions of toys to millions of less fortunate children. There's no way they can do all that work alone, so they have one simple message for all y'all. Anyone can be Santa. Think about it. It's pretty empowering, right? And it's been really inspiring for all of us here at the Opry, too. Just take a look at what happened backstage the other night.
I am Santa. 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 I am Santa.
I am Santa.
I am Santa.
I am Santa.
Dustin, we need to go deliver these toys.
No. I'm Santa. See?
Well, that's the thing about Toys for Tots. Anyone can be Santa. Come on.
How about a hand for Toys for Tots? When it comes to the country music world, country music is about family. And if you stay around the Grand Ole Opry very long, you just see we're just one big family. And so I have a cousin who comes from Spearfish, South Dakota, came in for the holidays, and when he walks in a room, everything brightens up. He's cool, and he's funny, and there is a family resemblance. And he's center stage right now. How about a hand for Gary Mule Deer, ladies and gentlemen? Cuz?
Matt. Thank you. Just came in from the parking lot. It's windy out there. The taste of love is sweet when hearts like ours meet. I felt for you like a child. Oh, but the fire went wild. I fell in. Oh, no. A couple of months ago, I checked into a hotel. There's a Bible beside the bed. I opened it up. There's a message inside that said, "If you are an alcoholic, you think you have a drinking problem, please call this number." I called it. It was a liquor store. Let it out, folks. Doesn't get any better. My grandpa used to say, listen, if we all liked the same things, everybody'd be after your grandma. Grandpa used to say some weird things. One time I said, Grandpa, what's the quickest way to get to the lake? He said, you walking or driving? I said, I'm driving. He said, that's the quickest. I make fun of Grandpa. Actually, he was pretty successful. He was a veterinarian and a taxidermist. I remember the sign said, no matter what happens, you'll get your dog back. God, you guys are great. Want to go to Denny's later? Took Grandpa to Denny's one time. The coffee was cold, the eggs were runny, hash browns were soggy, the toast was burned. As we were leaving, Grandpa turned to the cashier and he said, my compliments to the photographer. So one time I said, Grandpa, you very political. Grandpa said, all politicians should serve just two terms, one in office and one in prison. That's what he said. Oh, yeah. Good heavens, let's lighten this up a little bit. Something from a Walt Disney film with political overtones. Super frantic, unproductive, nothing legislation. Want to change your congressman, provide some lubrication. CEOs cannot complain of overregulation. Voters get what you deserve, great procrastination. From super PACs of unproductive, nothing legislation. That's it. I think I have politics figured out. Tell me what you think. My son was flunking out of college. He said, I'm going to choose a woman for you to marry. He said, no. I said, she's Bill Gates' daughter. He said, okay. I called Bill Gates, said, I want your daughter to marry my son. He said, no. I said, he's the CEO of World Bank. He said, okay. I called the president of World Bank. I said, I want you to make my son the CEO. He said, no. I said, he's Bill Gates' son-in-law. He said, okay. So the senator visits an Indian reservation. He walks up to the chief. He says, got any problems here? Chief said, we have three. Senator said, what's your first problem? Chief said, well, we got this mine up here. All the tailings have come down, polluted our water. We have to truck it in. Very expensive. Senator whips out his cell phone, walks off, yells in it a couple minutes, comes back, puts his cell phone back in his pocket, says, okay, I'll tell you what. At the end of this week, we're going to start drilling two new wells for you. We're going to reimburse you for all the water. What's your second problem? Chief said, well, we got this medical facility. We don't have any doctors. Senator whips out his smartphone, walks off, yells in a couple minutes, comes back, puts his cell phone back in his pocket, says, okay, I'll tell you what. At the end of this month, we're going to have five doctors here. At the end of 6 months, we'll have a fully staffed medical facility. He said, now, what's your third problem? Chief said, no cell service. I think every woman's dream is to have a man walk up to her, pick her up in his arms, carry her into the bedroom, throw her down on the bed, and then clean the entire house while she sleeps. Yeah, all right, there we go. You guys want to do a sing-along? All right, you do the words. Oh, you want the words. Here's the words. Taco Bell tastes three times better. Tastes just like a Chihuahua sweater. For God's sake, people, we have kids here tonight. I hope there's kids here tonight. Do we have some kids here? Let's hear it. Great. Kids, I'm gonna play a dog song for you kids, but first, I wanna give you a couple of tips. I call these tips for kids. First tip, only brush the teeth you want to keep. And number two, just think, if YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook all become one company, we can call them U-Twit-Face. And now, here comes that song. This will be your favorite dog song ever. I want a pit bull. I want a pit bull. I want a pit bull. I want a fuzzy little puppy with an evil grin that'll tear that bone right out of your shin. I want a pit bull. I want a pit bull. I want a stocky little puppy that's always pissed that'll fetch that bone right out of your wrist. I want a pit bull. Well, that concludes the children's portion of my show. So this lady comes out of heart surgery and God is standing at the foot of the bed. She says, am I going to die? God said, you have 30 more years. She feels so good, she stays in the hospital. She gets liposuction, she gets her breasts enhanced, gets her neck pulled back, gets an eyebrow lift, a nose job, and collagen in her lips. She leaves the hospital as she's walking across the parking lot. She gets hit by an ambulance. 2 days later, she's standing in heaven. She runs into God. She said, I thought I had 30 more years. He said, I'm sorry, I didn't recognize you. Here's a word about Folgers coffee for senior citizens. The best part of waking up is just waking up. Yeah. A couple months ago, a girl rode by me on a bicycle. I yelled, cow. She turned around and flipped me off. Then she hit the cow. 88-year-old Harriet calls 90-year-old husband Harvey. He said, Harvey, you driving on Interstate 40? He said, yep. She said, for God's sakes, be careful. There's some idiot out there in a car driving the wrong way. Harvey said, one idiot? Hell, there's hundreds. Old guy's walking down the hall in this retirement home. He sees this door open. He walks in. There's this old lady standing there. He walks up to her. He says, bet you can't guess how old I am. He says, I bet you I can. Drop your pants. He drops his pants. She says, you're 96. He said, gee, you're right. How did you know? She said, you told me at breakfast this morning. So, 60-year-old couple are celebrating their 40th wedding anniversary. They're walking along a beach. A genie appears. I'm going to give you each one wish. Takes the wife to the side and says, well, the wife said, oh, I always wanted to travel the world for a couple of years. Just like that, fistful of airline tickets, helicopter arrives, takes her off to a cruise ship. Genie turns to the husband and says, what about you? Husband says, you know, I've always kind of wanted a wife 30 years younger than me. And just like that, he was 90. Guy calls up his boss and says, I'm sick. His boss says, what's wrong? The guy says, I have anal glaucoma. His boss says, what's that? The guy says, I really can't see my ass coming into work today. Okay, one more. So this lady's walking by a pet store. She sees this parrot. She goes in and says, how much is for that parrot? The owner says, $20. She said, $20? That parrot's beautiful. He said, $20. She said, what's wrong with it? He said, nothing, but actually, I have to warn you, it was raised in a brothel. She says, don't worry about it. For $20, I'll take my chances. She takes a parrot home, hangs him in the front room, goes to fill the water dish, comes out. The parrot says, ooh, pretty lady, pretty lady. About that time, her daughters walk in. The parrot says, ooh, pretty girls, pretty girls. Her husband walks in. The parrot says, hey, Kevin. I got to go. You guys have been great. God bless you, Marty Stewart. 30 years. Thank you.
Hi, cuz.
Oh, bud. Hey, cuz.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Thank you for coming all the way from South Dakota to see us tonight.
Oh, man, it was worth it. Look at this. Yeah. This is great.
Isn't this beautiful?
Isn't good as it gets.
Sorry I didn't get to make it up there. All the folks good? Grandma?
Grandma.
Yeah?
I'd tell you a story about Grandma once.
Ooh.
My grandma was pretty incredible. One time I said, Grandma, have you seen a little pill bottle lying around here and on the label in big letters it says LSD? And she said, well, no, I haven't. And then she said, did you see that dragon in the kitchen?
Gary Muledeer, ladies and gentlemen. Like family.
Opry Live is sponsored in part by Dish Network.
Hey, good. Gary,
yeah.
I love when you're on the Opry.
Oh, thank you. I love being here.
I think we all love when you're on the Opry. Am I right? Now,
thank you.
We just... Oh. You prepared for that. I love it.
I just always have a little money extra. It never hurts to be prepared.
It never does.
No.
Do you tell us when your Opry debut was?
Well, remember the Civil War?
I don't remember it, but I heard about it.
I think it was when I was doing Nashville Now, TNN, back in those days, and I was a regular on Hee Haw the last year and a half. That was my first one. I think I've done now a little over 150, maybe.
My goodness, 150
Opry. Pretty close, yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
What do you remember about your Opry debut? Do you?
You know what? They've all been good. I've never had a bad show here. It's impossible to have a bad show here.
I agree with
Honestly,
you on that.
I mean it. I mean, some guy once said it's lonely on the road. Nobody heard him.
See?
Exactly. Do you you think you were more nervous for your Opry debut or for Johnny Carson show?
You know what? It never really made any difference. I never wanted to do anything else, so I made sure I never got nervous.
Wow.
I just made sure I never had anything to fall back on.
Yeah.
That's all it is. I was a 7-year freshman. That's a record. I had 33 incompletes and an A in archery, okay?
Well, who were some of the comedians that inspired you to want to do
this? Well, mine go way back to the days of, I grew up with radio, so people like Jack Benny and people like that, they go way, way back. And I came up with guys like Jerry Seinfeld, and I came up with Steve Martin, and I were probably bonded together in the early 60s, before there were comedy clubs. We played all music clubs. I was gravitated toward musicians. That's why I'm here. I'm more so than I am for comedians. I always found the really good musicians to hang out with. And you know what? After 60 years, I'm still doing it.
Oh, it is amazing. Well, we are so happy to have you on the Opry. Thank you for being
a part of
this special night with Mr.
My
Martin
pleasure.
Stewart. You are
Thank
the best. You. Oh, see, that's why I need to have money in my pocket to throw at him for that one right there. Y'all, isn't this just the best night ever? Well, I get to go ahead and give it back over to the man of the evening, Mr. Marty Stewart.
First two records I ever owned that I could call my own was a Lester Flatt and Earl Scruggs record and a Johnny Cash record. And the sound of bluegrass music, banjos and fiddles and mandolins, is part of my heart. And nobody at this point in time does it better than these gentlemen right here, Modern Masters in Motion. Would you please, my family, my friends, how about a hand for the Dale McCurry Band, ladies and gentlemen?
Oh, thank you, folks. Well, you know what? Now, I wish you folks, I know you've heard this guy play all night here tonight, but we want to get him to help us do a little tune here. How about a little hand for the original Nashville Cat right there, huh? Right here he is. Marty Stewart, right there.
I said that I met you when I was playing in Lester Flatt's band.
That's right.
And the kind of music that those guys started, you guys have kept it going, but furthered it and doing such a great job taking it to new generations and new people. But I don't want to let this show get away without honoring Lester. If we could do honor Lester, Lester and Earl and the Foggy Mountain Boys.
Yeah.
What do you think? Mr. McCurry, what do you got on your mind?
Tell him what you got there.
We'll play probably the most famous banjo tune of all time. I would say the Foggy Mountain Breakdown.
That's the one we want to hear. Thank you.
Humana, proud partner of the Grand Ole Opry. It's not just healthcare, it's human care.
Some mighty fine picking with the Del McCurry Band and Marty Stewart, am I right? Wow. Well, y'all, I'm Natalie Stovall once again. It is such a pleasure to be here, get to chat with everybody here in the house tonight, everybody who's tuned in on WSM 650 AM, all of our live streamers tuned in from around the world, and I'm hanging out with y'all while TV is in their commercial breaks. Now, I want to make sure and mention this once again, because I mentioned earlier that one of our sponsors tonight is the amazing Toys for Tots organization. And like me, y'all probably thought that they're pretty much all about giving toys to the less fortunate children during the holidays, which is absolutely true and amazingly fantastic, but they have expanded their mission to support children in need all year long. They now have year-round programs for disadvantaged children who have exceptional circumstances, Native American children to assist with their development with books and toys, literacy development to distribute books and resources to disadvantaged children, and most recently, Afghanistan refugee children who are right here in the United States who receive toys and gifts. And what's really amazing is that most of these programs are active in all 50 states. But to keep their mission alive, they need all of our help. We can support them by donating a toy, making a monetary donation, or by volunteering, because remember, we can all be Santa. Find out what Toys for Tots is doing in your town by visiting toysfortots.org. Now, another amazing sponsor that we have here at the Opry that's helping us bring this incredible show to y'all is Bass Pro Shops. And y'all, Santa has arrived. Santa is at Bass Pro Shops across the country, and he'll be there to help your family celebrate Christmas at Bass Pro Shops in Santa's Wonderland. Now through Christmas Eve, you can obtain a reservation. Get that, a reservation for a free photo with the bearded guy. All you got to do is go to basspro.com/Santa, and it's all to help y'all get you and your family to celebrate the magic of Christmas and make a lifelong memory for your family by getting that photo with Santa. That's what makes it feel like it's really the holiday season, doesn't it? Be sure and go to basspro.com/Santa. Now, one more time, y'all, make me look good for those television folks tuning in. Come on. Welcome back. Y'all, 51 years ago, Marty had his first Opry moment. Right there on that piece of wood, his 13-year-old self stood next to Lester Flatt and performed under the watchful eyes of Roy Acuff, Bill Monroe, and Tex Ritter. He later said it was like looking into the face of the Old Testament of country music. Well, Marty, thanks for never losing sight of that Old Testament, for holding it close to your heart, and for playing from it every single time you pick up an instrument. Now, if you please, bring us on home, Brother Stewart.
Thank you, Natalie. Thank you. Oh, wow. Superlatives. A good night. The best part about all these years is friends and family. I would like to thank the lady on the back pew back there sitting next to my sister Jennifer. My mama is here. How about a hand for Hilda Stewart? Stand up, Mama. Mama turned 89 years old yesterday. How about that? Happy birthday to you. Jennifer and I went down to Gulfport, Mississippi to visit our grandparents one time. And back in the summer of 1968, I came home. And Mama had bought both of us a bicycle and bought Jennifer a Loretta Lynn record. And bought me a record called Johnny Cash at Folsom Prison that I've been dying to get, but you couldn't get it. It was so hot. And that record still is my favorite record, period. It's my very favorite country record. And I finally got to go to Folsom Prison and tour. And when I went inside, I wanted to see a place called Greystone Chapel. Greystone Chapel was the name of a song in that record written by an inmate named Glenn Shirley. He had no idea John was going to do this song. The night before the show, they sit Glenn Shirley right there in the front row, and John sprung it on him, and the next thing you know, Glenn Shirley is a household word. And so we would like to go back to that record right now, I'm in the superlatives, and to the Folsom Prison record. And this is a song called Greystone Chapel for J.R. Cash, all right?
Inside the walls of a prison, my body may be, but the Lord has set my soul free. There's a graystone chapel here at Folsom, a house of worship in this den of sin. Oh, you would think that God had a place here at Folsom, where it saved the souls of a many lost men. This graystone chapel here at Folsom stands 100 years old, made of solid rock. Takes a ring of keys to move them here at Folsom, but the door to the house of God is never locked. Inside the walls of a prison, my body may be, but the Lord has set my soul free. There's men here who don't ever worship. There's men here who scoff at the ones who pray. Oh, but I got down on my knees in that graystone chapel, and I thank the Lord for helping me each day. This graystone chapel here at Folsom has a touch of God's hand on every stone. It's a flower of light in a field of darkness that has given me the strength to carry on. Inside the walls of a prison, my body may be, but the Lord has set my soul free. Inside the walls of a prison, my body may be, but the Lord has set my soul free. All right.
Hey, soldier. Yeah. All right.
Did you enjoy John Tavius Willis tonight is what I need to know. Did you enjoy the Dale McCurry Band is what I need to know. How about a hand for Miss Natalie Stovall and her fancy britches? All right. How about a hand for the fabulous superlatives? How about a hand for my cousin Gary Muldeer? All right. Here's a song called Country Star from the new record Altitude.
Jumping up and down, ain't that strange? It's a mystery. Just another 24 in the 365, 24/7, glad to be alive. All I need is a motor in my car, crank it up, hit the road, be a country star. Raised by alligators in the Pearl Swamp, started a dancing on the boogie woogie stump. Stump fell in, went to the bottom. Fish said, boys, smoke them if you got them. Ain't that strange? It's a mystery. Just another 24 in the 365, 24/7, glad to be alive. All I need is a motor in my car, crank it up, hit the road. Star.
Just another 24 in the 365. 24/7, glad to be alive. All I need is a motor and my car. Crank it up, hit the road, be a country star.
Thank you very much. Thanks for coming.